It's breakfast. We're having pancakes for breakfast. We still have the table set up because we're gonna do rocklet tonight. It worked out well that we didn't have to clean the top tonight, or yet last night. So it's ready for tonight. And Elliot, yeah, you're having some breakfast too. You're having Elliot pancakes, huh? Cam, do you like syrup? Uh-huh. That is Canadian maple syrup. So for sort of a snacking lunch, I made little pigs in a blanket. My dad used to always make these for Christmas Eve. We always had like a spread with lots of different types of food and dip. And since here in our family, we have a nice dinner for Christmas Eve. Here, Nini, here's a plate. And Roman likes to do a big meal on Christmas Eve, understandably so. I thought this would be a fun way to kind of add a little bit of family tradition.
My name's Pikachu.
You're Pikachu? Mm-hmm. What are we doing?
Going outside to the snow.
Oh!
Come on, Lydia.
Come on.
Look, come on, it's getting stronger. Out of nowhere, it just started snowing. So we're going outside.
Oh,
no! Elliot!
Callum, come on.
Callum, come on.
Yeah, come here. Callum, come on, see your hair.
Elliot, look at Papa.
Hey.
Oh,
eine Jacke. Linnea, ist du Schnee? Mhm. Mund auf, Callum. Oh, du hast Pixel in a blanket.
Yeah, food. It just started snowing.
Elliot.
Auf deine Haare sind
you like it?
Kann gar nicht sein. Bei mir ist 30 Grad warm.
He's in my jacket. I can't believe this. Can you believe this? What, did you know it was supposed to snow?
I just checked the weather for until 10 and it didn't say anything.
Okay.
But
it's his first snow. Do you like it? He's also chewing. Yeah, we were sitting down to lunch and it just started snowing.
Und fang eine Schneeflocke mit deinem Mund, Kellen. Kellen, fang eine Schneeflocke mit dem Mund. Fang die da. Die, fang sie. Linnea, du auch? Komm her. Ja, komm. Ja, komm her, Linnea. Komm her. Okay, schau mal nach oben. Dann nimm genau die Schneeflocke, die da runterkommt. Mit deinem Mund, fang mit deinem Mund.
Hey everybody, first and foremost, I just want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas. Christmas was technically yesterday, but this is the first time I'm able to really just sit down by myself without anybody. All the kids are happily playing in the living room, at least for right now. We'll see how long this lasts. Christmas was for us very quiet. We had a very quiet day, which is nice. It felt very different having Elliot. I mean, having a baby in the family was quite different again. It blows my mind really just how fast it goes, how fast time goes, because I remember this time last year, I was 8 months pregnant with Elliot. And, you know, I was getting to that point where I knew it was too early for him to come, but I was also totally ready to meet him and just overflowing with excitement. You know, all the feelings that come when you're about to have a baby and just wondering who this person's gonna be and just really feeling the connection. I say this a lot. I say this probably every year, but just feeling the real connection to the Virgin Mary, just knowing what it feels like to have aches and pains in your body from a growing uterus that's growing a human, and just, you know, being 8 months pregnant, you're not a tiny bump anymore. You know, there's a real baby bump there, and you can sort of just put yourself in the shoes of Mary in the nativity story, and you find a deeper meaning to Christmas, I think, once you become a parent yourself, especially a mother. And it takes on a whole other meaning when you think about it being the birth of Jesus. And I've had the honor of being pregnant, highly pregnant, with all three of my babies at Christmas time. So with all three of my pregnancies. So last year was really special, and I kept thinking that this year would be the year that we would have Elliot, that he would be with us in our arms, and just what would Christmas look like. And it's just crazy that a whole year has passed since then, and now we're here, and he was with us, and it was special and completely different than I imagined our Christmas would be, experiencing a pandemic. And I just sort of felt a bit low that we weren't able to like visit Stuttgart at all this Christmas season. And obviously when we were in Stuttgart the last time, our visit was cut short due to rising COVID numbers, and it's another milestone, another holiday, another memory that we're unable to share with family. But I just felt determined that I wasn't going to let those feelings creep in and steal the joy of experiencing my son's first Christmas and being able to spend the time with my family. And that even though it's different than I think many of us would have imagined Christmas being this year, I'm focusing on the good and the immense blessing that we have, that we welcomed a life this year into our family. I don't take any of that for granted. So it was a very, very heavy Christmas, I think, because of those emotions. The expectations were quite different, I think, than what I had expected. But then I also think, isn't that kind of how the original Christmas story was? I can't imagine, you know, Mary saying, hey, I would just love to give birth in hay, surrounded by strangers and animals, and not even on a proper bed. So it kind of makes me laugh a little bit, you know, when I think about that. It was different than I think we had imagined it would be this time last year when we were imagining our first Christmas with Elliot. But it was still very, very, very special. And the snow today makes me cry a little bit, because I had a dream last night that it was going to snow. I had a dream, and I woke up thinking, it's just a dream, that's not gonna happen. But I thought, man, if only it did happen, if only it could happen, if only we could just get some snow. We were all sitting having lunch. We were all sitting at the table, and the kids were starting to serve themselves lunch. And then Roman said, it's snowing. And I was like, what? No, what are you talking about? And I turned around and we saw snow. And we looked at the kids and we're like, get your shoes on, get your jackets, we're gonna go outside. They were like, we're not wearing clothes. I was like, I don't care, go outside, let's go. And it was magic that you couldn't plan. Hi, you wanna come up here? Here comes Elliot. Hey, did you need mommy? Yeah. Basically, whatever will be, so. We're good. We're happy. We had a great, great Christmas, special Christmas, Elliot's first Christmas, and I just wanted to hop on here and share those thoughts with you guys, and just send big hugs to all of you, a big virtual hug to all of you, and just wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Check this out.
I'm watching you drive. I like how the lights are on. Ooh, that's cool. Somebody's a happy little boy, and that makes me a very happy mom.